Have you got something to say to the nice boys and girls, Georgie?
Yes.
What are you saying?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, presenting the fabulous, the fantastic Flying Fruit Fly Circus.
This is a story about a bunch of ordinary kids from Australia. They have become one of the most extraordinary performing troupes in the world. The story begins in eastern Australia on the banks of the Murray River. That's the border between the states of New South Wales and Victoria. Here on the main highway between Sydney and Melbourne are the twin country towns of Albury and Wodonga. The combined population is around 70,000 people. The Flying Fruit Fly Circus gets its name from a tiny insect in the district that somehow gets into fruit and spoils it. They used to have roadblocks on the highway just out of town to stop people carrying fruit across the border. Today, there's a new breed of fruit fly getting about the streets here. One of them is Jason Newman. He juggles, he does pole climbing, and he can ride a 10-foot unicycle. He's only 13, and he's already been in over 100 shows. He's just one of 60 kids, aged between 6 and 18, who come to train at this old YMCA gym in Albury every day. Fruit flies, the first part of the school day is spent at a little wooden schoolhouse just over the border in Wodonga. Here, the kids are able to do their normal schoolwork in classes with children their own age, and then get together later in different groups at the gym to work on their circus acts. So training is included in the school timetable, all of which means long days, but the kids wouldn't swap it for anything. You can only be a fruit fly while you're still at school. It all began in 1979 as a holiday project put on by the Murray River Performing Group for the local kids to celebrate the International Year of the Child. It was an opportunity for them to put on their own circus, and they did. It was only ever meant to be just that one show, but it had such a huge effect on the people of the district. Everybody liked it so much that somehow it just had to keep going. This is Australia's very first school of acrobatic arts and performance skills. It's had such an impact that acrobats and circus performers have come here from all over the world to pass on their skills to the fruit flies. But there's more to being a fruit fly than the excitement of performing in front of a big audience. For every circus performance, there's months of training and a lot of hard work that takes real dedication. Keeping fit every day with warm-ups and basic training exercises. Making sure, always, that what you do is safe. Taking care of the circus props and equipment. Being responsible for yourself and listening to others, especially the trainers.
We're not talking about togs now while we're doing
the perfect. Hi, my name's Georgie and I'm going to show you around the prop room. This is a fly. Aerial ladders. Juggling stuff. Juggling baton. Unicycles. helmet. And donga. Sign, knockabout table, and... Yeah!
Months later, preparations are underway for one of the circus's most ambitious projects yet. They're putting up a brand new 1,200-seat big top for 3 weeks of shows in hometown Albury as well as in Canberra. That's the nation's capital city. But first, all the acts have to come together.
I don't know which one. I can't form this one going round, turning. So I want to do both, but I think both might look silly as a joke. What, this one?
No, this one. Yeah, do this one.
Liu Gong Long is one of seven acrobats from Nanjing who have come to Australia like to work with the fruit flies since 1984.
Not easier, but look,
this was the first time Chinese acrobats had ever come to a Western country to teach.
Is it harder?
He's back again this year to help Heather, Mary and Jackie with one of the most spectacular and most difficult of all the circus acts, the Tower of Chairs. It's an act of strength, balance and precision. And it takes a special kind of trust and understanding to perform it.
This is Jackie's first time at the chairs, and for Mary and I, it's our last. So we want to try and pass on as much as we can.
We will train 24 hours a day if we have to, but we just rely on so many other people to get the act together that we're limited with time.
Oh, the table's over there, yeah.
The new king poles look like they might just work. Brand new cables, canvas, nuts and bolts. A whole new big top kit. Twice the size the fruit flies are used to. Will everything hold? The crew checks everything. All the helpers just know it's going to work.
For me, the battle is the strength to hold those three chairs to my left and two people, as well as do the handstand. We've all got to balance, we've all got to concentrate, and we've all got to be strong in our handstand. Heather, she's got people on both sides of her. She's got to try and balance as well as have the strength to do her handstand.
No, look, you have to communicate. If you don't communicate, like, you have to communicate when we're up there, even in the performance. And Jackie, you know, has to communicate with the person putting up the chair to make sure that it's on properly so they can let go. And if it's not right, well, we tell each other and we don't do it.
Yeah. How much harder is it to get up on the bottles than it is just on the table?
It's definitely psychological. I don't think there is much difference, the bottles being there or not.
Got it?
It's okay.
The big difference actually is when you're performing on top of the chairs, if you actually do move, like if Jackie comes down on those group chairs quite heavily and those bottles move, then that's when it becomes really dangerous.
Now, Jackie, it just means that you have to be, when you step on these chairs, you just have to be more careful when you step. Not slower, but just step lighter, so everything's smooth. Okay. Can I get it? Oh, now come down. Hang on, shut up.
Time is short. Tempers sometimes get frayed. But there's a real feeling of working together here. While Jackie and the others in the troupe are rehearsing hard on their acts, there are teams of people all over the place. Teams of kids and their families figuring out ways of helping. Will the winches hold? Will it all come together in time?
Why not? I bet.
I can.
Yeah, why not?
Now,
yeah,
that other leg. Watch the other leg.
Come on, do it like you do it before. Done it 10 million times before. Jackie, it's exactly the same. You right?
Yeah, it's good.
Good.
Slowly, no, head on up. Hey, okay, that's up. Not?
No, no. Okay, girls, team, go. Take it down then. See, every time you put a bend in that rope, you tighten it. And you can go around this way again if you have enough rope.
Tent's looking great. The quarter poles and side poles fit just right. The seating banks, steps, stringers, jacks and flooring go in next. There's less than a week to go now to opening night. Everyone's tired. All the helpers, the parents, the kids, even the film crew. But the tent is finally up. Tomorrow, full-scale rehearsals can begin. And there's still a million other things to do.
Four, hinge, two, three, four, and over.
48 hours to go. Rehearsals in the tent are at full pitch now. Warm-ups, practice and more practice. Meetings at the start and end of every session to make sure it all comes together.
And do the exit. And we're trying to run things to time, particularly getting things on and off. So it's the ringwaiters are trying to run things to time.
So we've got one more rehearsal on Saturday afternoon. We've got to run it right through, no stops then. So tonight we've really got to try and work those things out so everyone knows exactly what they do.
Okay, off you go, Tom. Watch out.
The last time the circus performed was nearly a year ago. For some kids, this will be their last season with the fruit flies. For others, it'll be the very first time in front of an audience. The final decisions about who's doing which act and the running order of the acts have been sorted out. The lighting and safety systems have been set up and checked. Everybody's confident, but also just a little nervous. For the first time, to a hometown audience. It's going to be a packed house.
/news/, the Tingle Brothers have escaped. They're mean. They're rough. They're killers. They're to be shot on sight.
Tingle's in the tent.
Come
on, let's go. Let's go, wave the camera. Okay, stop waving the camera.
Make sure you've got the shoulder pole set right after town, too.
Okay, who's got the culture?
Okay, let's put
the culture. Oh, Georgie, you're getting filled in the neck of
Thank you.
Well, it's been a week of sell-out performances, but there's more to come. The next stop is Canberra, overnight by bus along the highway.
And how do you like the circus so far, boys? Leon, why have you got your back to the camera?
Sorry.
And what do you three do in the circus?
Clowning. Clowning.
Do you like it?
Yes.
And what do you want to do when you grow up, you three?
Clowning. I'm a circus. Clowning.
Okay, that's enough from the three tingles. Let's go. Okay, thanks a lot, fellas. You can run off now.
Kids tend to want to wander down and sit on the aisle ways. We don't mind.
Is it?
They sit in front of those.
Yeah,
they don't.
I don't understand all this.
It's chaos, isn't it?
Oh, is it chaos?
It's not chaos.
No.
Isn't that so smart?
No, you feel restrained throughout the performance. They may want to join in, but it's not such a good idea. The other thing I have to say is that this being a last performance for a season, we sometimes lose performers at the end of seasons. And this time we're losing quite a few of the older kids. This is their last performance with the Fruit Flies. And that's a bit sad. So we wish them all the best, and this show is for them. Thank you.
I'm sadder than they are, I think.
Thank you.